That historic move in the price for oil moving into negative territory still weighing on markets today. And while the May contract did bounce back, the June contract was in the red, dropping by more than 50%, so Canadian oil followed suit. So this put pressure on Bay and Wall Street as earnings continued rolling in. IBM, as an example, missed on revenue estimates for its fiscal first quarter while beating on the earnings side, but it also withdrew its full-year guidance. There are also questions about the health of the North Korean leader, with some reports suggesting he is in critical condition. And then as well today, the U.S. government did agree on a new pandemic relief plan to provide funds to small business as well as aid for testing and hospitals. There was a jump in shares of Beyond Meat today. And here's why. The fake meat company says it's entering the Chinese market through a partnership with Starbucks. The world's second largest economy represents an important market because China consumes more than a quarter of the world's meat by volume. I want to correct something I told you about yesterday. So at one point, Shopify surpassed the TD Bank in market cap, and it looked like it was the most valuable company on the TSX. It was actually the second most valuable, right behind RBC. Now, shares in Shopify today did snap an eight-day winning streak after earlier hitting another all-time high. 3M has filed a lawsuit over deceptive online retail sales and price gouging related to N95 masks. And two American fans are suing Major League Baseball. The pair of fans from New York are suing the league, the commissioner, and the league's 30 teams, asking for their money back and for certification of class action status, which would allow other fans in. The lawsuit was filed in Los Angeles by the fans who purchased tickets for games, which of course were put on hold because of the pandemic. Now, the suit says baseball fans are stuck with expensive and unusable tickets for unplayable games in the midst of this economic crisis. Ticket merchants are refusing to issue refunds for games because the games have been postponed, even though they won't be played as scheduled. In the 680 Business Center, I'm Chris McCusker. COVID.